Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I am Swati. Today I am here to discuss with you the most important point, that is how to find a house in Germany. I mean, I faced so many problems and I am sure that some of you are facing the same. So here I am sharing my experience with you so that you will get an idea. There are so many factors you have to look after while finding a good place. So in this video, we will go topic by topic, and at the end, I am going to tell you guys about the scams which you should be careful of while finding an apartment. The first point is number of rooms. You need to find an apartment on the basis of number of people living with you. If you are single, then Ein Zimmer WOHNUNG will be good for you. It will include one room with attached kitchen and bathroom. If you are living with your partner, then Zwei Zimmer WOHNUNG will be good for you. It will include one bedroom, living room, kitchen and bathroom. If you are living with your partner and one or two children, then you must go for Drei Zimmer WOHNUNG. It will include two bedrooms, one living area, one kitchen and bathroom. If your family is bigger, then you should go for Vier or Fünf Zimmer WOHNUNG. The second point is rent. In Germany, the rent has been divided into two parts, that is Kalt Miete and WOHNUNGSUCHEN. The Kalt Miete is actual rent of the apartment, and the WOHNUNGSUCHEN includes Kalt Miete plus heating, water and maintenance charges. These charges are normally 100 to 200 euro and these are not fixed. If you use more water and heating, then at the end of the year, your owner will ask for the cost of extra consumption. Also, you have to consider the caution money or deposit. This has to be paid while making the contract. The deposit is generally 3 times or 2 times of the Kalt Miete. Generally, electricity and internet are not considered in the rent. You have to make your own contract with the respective companies. How to do it? I will explain it in the upcoming points. The third point is furnished or unfurnished apartment. In furnished apartment, you will get all the necessary amenities included in it, like sofa, bed, TV, kitchen utensils, and in unfurnished, you will get an empty flat and you have to buy everything. They both have their own pros and cons. In furnished apartment, moving in and moving out is very easy because you don't have to worry about buying or selling stuff. In unfurnished apartment, you have to buy your own stuff and sell it whenever you are moving out. But for renting furnished apartment, you have to pay more rent as compared to the unfurnished apartment because you will going to pay extra rent for the furniture in-house. Now, what about kitchen? Sometimes apartments have fully equipped kitchen that is known as Einbauküche. It includes hot plates, refrigerator, oven, shelves, dishwasher, sink and all. Now we have all sorted with our requirements, it's time to know where to find. There are so many websites like eBay, WG-Gesucht, Immobilien Scout. You have to create a profile on this website with your correct information. Add a good profile photo, and if you are living with your family, then add a family photo. It matters. It gives face to your application. There are better chances of your application to get a response from owner. The next step is how to apply. You have already created profiles on websites. Now put on the filters like your maximum rent, area, Einbauküche, furnished or unfurnished. Then it will show many properties matching to your criteria. Select a property and send him a message. Your message must include who are you, where do you work, where are you from, what is your family status, do you have kids, then how many, do you have pets or not, whether you smoke or not. Write him clearly why do you want to rent this apartment. Sometimes there are delays in replies, sometimes no reply. If the owner or broker replies you, he will inform you with the date and time of the visit to the apartment. Be punctual. It's very important. you like the apartment, then owner will ask you for more documents like income proof, identity proof. Many times owner will ask for SHUFA. What is SHUFA? SHUFA is basically your credit score. You can get it easily from any websites like Immobilien Scout for around 30 to 40 euros. I will put all the links in the description box below. If everything goes well, owner will call you to sign the contract. On the same day, he will note all the damages in the property, and also he will note all the readings of electricity, heating and water. Once the contract has been signed, he will ask you for the caution money. Now you have signed the contract and want to move into your new apartment. The very first thing you need to do is make a contract with electricity company. In Germany, whenever you move to a new apartment, you need to make your own electricity contract with the company. It's pretty easy. Search for the provider company, go to their website, select the plan and give your bank details, and the contract will be done in 2 to 3 days. And also you have to make a contract with internet provider. It's as same as electricity. Search for the provider, go to their website, select a plan and your contract will be done. But note that the companies will take 20 to 25 days to give the connection, so make sure to make it in advance. Here we have reached to the last section of this video. I want to warn you about the scams happening in apartment searches. Sometimes you will see the ad with good pictures and affordable rent. Basically, this property will be very appealing. You apply the property, you get a message from owner that he lives abroad or on vacation or not in the city, but he can manage your visit to the apartment. He will ask you to deposit the money in some bank account, and he will also promise that you will get your keys after depositing the money. And also he will convince you that if you don't like the apartment, he will refund your money. Do not send the money to anybody. The genuine owner or broker will never ask you for the money in advance. In fact, the genuine owner or broker will prefer to meet you before signing the contract. If you send money to somebody like this, you will just lose your money and get nothing. So, precaution is better than cure. So if you find something fishy, like a good looking apartment in good area with lower price compared to the other apartment, so just think once. At last, I want to give you an advice that if you are planning to move to new place, then start looking for it before 2 to 3 months, because the process will take time. If you find this information helpful, then please like the video and share it with your friends and family. If you have any question or comment, then please let me know in the comment section below. And lastly, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever I post a new video. See you next time.